You're watching UNICEF Television. The effects of climate change are already causing havoc across Africa, with successive droughts throughout the continent leading to crop failure and starvation, while flooding has killed many and left many more homeless. While rich nations continue to debate responsibility, poorer nations suffer. But poorer nations are not helpless, and they are not idle. And nowhere is this more clear than in Zambia. This week saw the world's first National Children's Conference on Climate Change since the CCF, the Copenhagen Climate Forum, take place in the country's capital, Lusaka. The conference, which was attended by almost 200 children from all nine provinces of Zambia, was supported by UNICEF and government, but organized by Zambia's youth delegates to Copenhagen, who returned to their country determined to make a difference.
This came about after us attending the CCF, after us seeing the perpetual importance of having this conference, because we realized that most of the Zambians in Zambia don't really know about it. So when I tell somebody something, he will tell others, maybe three or four people, the same thing that he has learned. So that thing, information keeps on spreading. So, and we think that the dissemination of information will be quite high in Zambia of climate change.
The country's permanent secretary at the Ministry of Tourism, Environment and Natural Resources and UNICEF's Regional Director for Eastern and Southern Africa opened the Zambia Children's Climate Conference, which immediately launched participants into a series of lectures and adaptation and mitigation workshops. They learned not only the science behind climate change, but also about practical steps that they themselves can take to reduce their carbon footprint, such as tree planting, water harvesting, the use of drip irrigation, solar power, and other energy-saving tools. One of the many highlights of the conference was a visit by Zambia's First Lady, Tandiwe Banda, who spoke to delegates about the environmental issues affecting their country. The timing of the conference is significant. Zambia's natural environment is being rapidly destroyed. The country is now the second most deforested country on the planet, and recent floods attributed to climate change displaced over 1,000 people in Lusaka earlier this year. But the conference is also significant for the continent as a whole, as the exploitation of natural resources continues unabated throughout much of Africa, destroying forests, grasslands, waterways, soil, and all who rely upon them.
Climate change is central to everything we do with regard to development. Water is central to health, food production, and de facto nutrition. It's not only about protecting the tree that is important. It's not only about making sure that the sources of water are preserved, that is very important. But it's also about taking action on a daily basis, to make sure that what nature has given us be preserved.
The delegates also visited an environmental sanctuary on the outskirts of the city, where indigenous plants and animals are protected and rehabilitated. Here, the urgency of their mission hit home, and they were exposed to everything Zambia stands to lose if things don't change.
If we leave the climate change issue just like this as an issue without acting upon it, we shall have massive negative results in the future.
The delegates will return home to implement and disseminate all they've learned, and will reconvene in August to take stock. But for now, each one knows they can and must make a difference and spread the message of
Get Free!
This is Guy Hubbard reporting for UNICEF Television. Unite for Children.